Roberto Ferreira, and I live in the south of Johannesburg, in Limbuster, and I'm here to talk to you today about the disease of addiction and to let you know that there's help and hope. Okay, so I grew up in the south of Johannesburg since the age of two. I believe I came from a normal, functional family. I never had to want for anything. My parents are still together. Two siblings. There was always food on the table. We always had our school fees paid, so I never had any real issue with regards to that. I went to Glenander Primary School for 7 years, so I didn't change schools that often. I only changed school when it was time to go to high school, and I attended Glenbuster High School for 5 years and completed my schooling there in 2002. So initially in high school, I didn't really drug that much. I do remember being at a house party when I was about 16 years old. I did try marijuana for the first time, but it landed up only being for a first time. When I did actually get introduced to drugs properly, I was at about the age of 20. I got introduced to it by a lady friend that I was dating at that time. The drug was called Cat, and I started using that with a mixture or cocktail with alcohol. Those became my drugs of choice. So when I first started using Cat, I didn't know where to get it or how to do it. My girlfriend didn't know. Basically, she got it from her hometown initially, but very soon afterwards, we started finding places and means much closer to home for us to find. I believe it's very easily accessible to get drugs. It's probably more common than how many pubs there are around in the area. So I did use other drugs. What I found was that I did dabble in quite almost all of them, but I found that I enjoyed using Cat much more. So what I started doing was I would try cocaine and ecstasy, those kind of things, but then coming back to Cat, for me that was my drug of choice. It did it for me. And it was much cheaper and easier to access. It would last me much longer. So I started using Cat at 20, as I said, and I stopped at about the age of 27. So I believe I started using drugs. It was a pure case of boredom and too much time on my hands. I also believe I wasn't educated on the dangers of drugs. I thought it would be a case of using drugs, trying it out, and then it would be I would be able to stop using. I found that the first time I ever used drugs, then I was hooked and I couldn't stop. But I did believe that whenever I wanted to stop, I could stop. It just was not the time right now to stop. And I couldn't stop on my own when it was time. I had to be, there was an intervention done on me by family, which helped me to remove me from the situation I was in. Okay, so for quite a while, there was no awareness of my usage of drugs from my immediate family. I do not know exactly when they started to find out, but I do know it was plus minus when I was 24. But they didn't believe it was a drug issue. They thought it was me having a problem with the family. They took me to a psychologist and did family counseling there. Until such time, it was suggested to them by a family support group that they should check if I'm using drugs. They took me to my local GP and I did a blood test that checked for drugs and it came out positive. Once that happened, then they basically guided me in the direction of a fellowship for people that do suffer from drug addiction, and then I got admitted into a drug rehabilitation center. So when my family first found out that I was a problem child, before they knew that I was actually using drugs, every time there was a confrontation, basically my reaction was to try and leave the vicinity as soon as possible because I didn't really want to face any kind of confrontation. I just wanted to be left to my own devices and use and do what I wanted to do without any kind of judgment or consequences. Eventually when it was time, I remember being taken to the GP. I didn't know that I was going there for myself. I was busy driving along there. And basically what happened was when I landed up there, they wanted me to go in for myself. So it was a bit of a trick, which is fine, I can understand that right now. Then I left the the GP without doing the test. My mom came with me and had a bit of a discussion or an argument in the car. And eventually I just decided, okay, that's fine, I'm going to go through with it. The drug test results did not come back immediately, but when they did, and I ended up at home, they didn't tell me that they got the results, and they did a search on me to find out if there was any drugs on my person. They did find drugs on me, and then they let me know that they found drugs, and obviously the drug test came back positive. My reaction to that was a huge amount of relief. At least I didn't have to deal with this on my own anymore. It was a long time me trying to hide it from them because I didn't want them to be disappointed or disregarded anymore or anything like that. So the first time they found out that I had a drug problem and I went to fellowship and I went to a rehab facility, I felt a huge sense of relief. I found cat to be my drug of choice, specifically because it gave me a huge sense of euphoria. They call it an upper drug. It helps you stay awake and it's like having an ecstasy except 100 times more effective. That's how I felt when I was high. Thereafter, when I didn't have the drug in my system anymore, it was a huge crash. You know, I'd basically sleep for a couple of days and I'd feel very uncomfortable and depressed and all those kind of things. And the only thing that I found that could fix it was to have that same drug again to lift me up to that same level. But I really did fall in love with the euphoric experience of that drug. So to elaborate more on the downside of the usage, I'd sleep for quite a while because I could not sleep while using. So there would be a couple of days of sleep. Also while using I couldn't eat. So what would happen is I'd also binge eat once I'd stop using. So I'd be eating a lot and sleeping a lot. A lot of depression, thinking, what am I doing? I can't get up, I can't face the day. Small things, for example, if it was overcast or raining and I wasn't using drugs, I would need to use drugs to face the day. That's how petty it had become, that small things like the weather would affect me. I would get quite angry and passive aggressive with people around me, because obviously they would come and worry about me and why I'm sleeping or what's the problem or what's going on with me, and I would just want them to leave me alone I would like to isolate from those people and not be anywhere around them. So it was also a huge sense of guilt because I knew that I was using drugs, and as we all know, drugs is illegal. So when I first started using drugs, I'd arrived back from staying in the UK. I'd come back and started studying a diploma at a college in the north of Johannesburg. My first year was okay because I hadn't started using drugs yet, but what happened thereafter was that I basically couldn't attend lectures and function and concentrate while I was at lectures. If I did attend college, it was just to basically be in attendance, and I was outside in the quad with the other students playing foosball, that kind of thing, or trying to eat or sleep. Or I would take drugs onto the campus. The end result is that I never completed my studies. I had every excuse in the book except to blame myself. Obviously that I was using drugs. So eventually, by dropping out, I did start getting into the workforce. And initially it was, you know, not so glamorous jobs. It was hard-working things, but also those jobs would affect me. My drug usage would affect those jobs. I never could manage to keep a job for more than 6 to 8 months. So I was chopped and changed from jobs, basically to run away from any kind of confrontation that I was at. If I thought things were getting too hot or people were in my case, I'd leave the employee and go somewhere else. What happened then is when I discussed the intervention with my family, then I did actually attend a rehabilitation center and managed to stay clean for such time. But I did eventually relapse after 21 months of not using drugs. And I went back to using basically everything that I had built up, I had lost again, and landed up in a treatment facility and the recovery program again. So I did have a bit of a period of clean time. However, I do believe, for me personally, it was a process, a learning curve, because there were certain things that I had not dealt with in my own personal life. And now I'm here sitting today, 3.5 years clean. So for me to access my drugs initially, I used to have a part-time job while studying. I used to use that money. Also, my girlfriend also had money and she would purchase herself. Initially, it was manageable whereby I had an X amount of money per month to use for on the drugs. And then eventually it got a bit more hectic where I'd use more money that I would normally use for petrol and other responsibilities to use drugs. Until such time that I didn't have enough money as an income and I would start borrowing from people, not paying them back, and stealing money from people, stealing things from people and pawning it to get the more drugs that I needed. What I also want to make quite clear was that I never used the same amount all the time. Initially it was maybe one bag a week, and when I ended off I was using about 15 bags a day. So the first treatment facility I ended up going to is based in Boksburg. It is a government facility. One thing that experience taught me was that I was not the only person that had a problem with drugs, because I did have a strong belief that yes, there were other people that used, but I was the only one that did not know how to do it properly, that I was the only one suffering from it. So it taught me or showed me that there were other people out there that had a problem. And also the fact that I went to a government institution showed me that the other people that were there, how far down the line they had gone. There were a lot of other people there that actually had nothing. They were kind of off the streets and much worse off than me. So it showed me that if I didn't carry on using drugs, eventually I'd get to that point. So there wasn't, unfortunately, as much education or support from that facility, because it's a government facility, to teach me how to stay clean, but I did manage to build up some time. I got 21 months clean, but then when I did relapse, what I found was a lot of the things that people told me would happen if I didn't stop using did happen to me. So in a period of 1 year stint of using drugs again, I ended up going to another treatment facility in the north of Johannesburg. This was a private institution, obviously much more expensive than the one that I had gone to first. Medical aid covered and all that kind of thing. Where they ran program every day, you'd be in group therapy, you'd have psychologists in group therapy, one-on-one counselling with different counsellors. So there's a lot of services that were offered. What that landed up doing was teaching me how to deal with my traumatic experiences that I've had, whereby I'd run away or escape from and use drugs. Because that was what actually was happening. I was escaping from reality and finding a comfortable place with the usage of drugs. And then what else they actually taught me was that there is a way after treatment. It's not a matter of going to a facility for 30 days and coming out and you're cured. It's more of a chronic disease whereby you have to have a constant and continuous treatment. There's fellowship groups outside of a treatment facility that you can attend. There's no excuse for me, at least, because I know in the south of Johannesburg there are 6 meetings a week that I can attend. And I have a support group and I surround myself with other people that are trying to live a new way of life. So I actually change the people that I hang out with and change the places that I actually go to for enjoyment and those kind of things. So I've had to change everything, otherwise I'd fall back to my old way of living. So some of the benefits that I have now for being clean is that I actually have a clean mind. I'm able to think clearer and smarter now, because my mind isn't affected by the use of drugs, because drugs is a mind-altering substance. I live more in reality now. Another thing that I've learned, and I've learned it the hard way, is life experiences. You know, a lot of the things that I have done or experienced during the act of addiction has taught me the hard way how to live life now, you know. Maybe to better explain it is that I knew how to live the wrong way, and now I must just do the opposite to live the right way. I'm able to pay my bills now. I'm able to not get stuck on the road without petrol because I've got the money for drugs. I don't have car accidents anymore and write off my cars. I complete things now that I never completed before. for when there are issues at home or at work, I don't run away from them. I stand there and I confront them, and it's a much healthier way to deal with life and also my relationships with people, all the way from family to friends to colleagues, are much better now because I feel that I'm a much more honest person and I do not run away from my issues. And I like to believe that I base my life on honesty and integrity. So where I'm at in my life now in terms of work, I work in a facility that helps and assists other people that are suffering from the disease of addiction. What we do there is we get people, like myself when I was using drugs, that don't know how to deal with it with regards to families and the actual drug addicts, and get them into a treatment facility sooner rather than later. What we do is, as well as we help them with those traumatic experiences, how to stop using drugs, exactly the same way it was for me, and I find for me personally, by me giving back, because there were other people that gave to me in the first place, helps me with my own recovery as well. It helps me to live a better life myself and teach others how to do it themselves too. It's like a big brother program or a charity thing whereby I give where I was given in the first place. Another way I do help is by attending the 12-step fellowships around the south of Johannesburg and other areas of Johannesburg. Basically, I do this help other people that are coming in with the problem of drug addiction, and by me living the lifestyle I do now, it shows others how to live their lives instead of the way they are currently using. So it's more of an outpost as well to help teach these guys that there's a new way of life. If I have any advice for teenagers or young people that are facing what I'm facing, if you're already using drugs, I just want to let you know that there is help out there. There is hope. If I can make it out of it, I believe other people can. If you are in a situation whereby you are being put under pressure by friends and you haven't used yet, don't do it. Rather feel the benefit of staying away from them and doing good at work, at school and college, and making new friends. You don't have to prove yourself to those people. From my own experience, that those people that I was trying to be cool with, I don't know where they are right now. So life moves on and life changes. And the advice I would try and give to parents or people that are surrounded by other people that are suffering from addiction is to educate yourselves. I believe knowing the nature of the disease of addiction will help or better equip you to help those individuals. Drug addiction is not a moral failing, it's a disease. There are fellowships and group supports in the south of Johannesburg specifically for family members and loved ones, but I believe that love and care and education and knowing more about the nature of this disease will help better equip you to help that individual. So I also want to make everyone aware that there is help around the south of Johannesburg, from 12-step fellowships to family support groups like Tough Love. There are treatment facilities. There's one in Rosettenville, it's called Sanka. Obviously they're part of a bigger group in the Gauteng and South African area. I do know of another treatment facility called Walking with Winners in the Walkable area. They also have an intervention squad called the SWAT team. So yes, and also I'm also aware of various church groups in the south that are actually more open-minded now and working towards helping individuals that do have a problem with drugs. I'm also involved in a treatment facility, but they aren't based in the south of Johannesburg, although we do outreach and interventions in all areas of Gauteng. It's called One to Be Free. So yes, we all have the common goal. That we are not in competition with each other. We all just want to help that person that is suffering from addiction and obviously their family members. We just want to change their current situation into a better situation, which will help the individual, family, the local community and business.